Suresh, you are watching Erola Suresh YouTube channel. Friends, in this video I'll explain about muscle tissue. Muscle tissue is also called as muscular tissue. Before going to know about the muscle tissue, first of all we should have awareness or we should have knowledge regarding the tissues present in animals. Tissue means a group of cells similar in structure and function. Each tissue will have a special function in the body. Like that, in animals, generally, four kinds of tissues are seen. The tissues in the animals are epithelial tissue, connective tissue, and muscle tissue, and nerve tissue. Already, I have made a video on nerve tissue. Now, I am doing video on muscle tissue. Let's concentrate on muscle tissue or muscular tissue. Okay, muscle tissue. What is the function of muscle tissue? Each tissue generally in the body will have a special function. In the same manner, muscle tissue also involved in the special function in organisms. So what is the special function of muscle tissue or muscular tissue? Muscle tissue is responsible for creation of movements or motion of the body. All our body parts can move, or we can move from one place to other place. Generally the animals or organisms move from one place to other place with the help of muscle tissue. So that we can understand, muscle tissue is responsible for movement of the body or movement of an organism. Okay, let's concentrate on the structure and functions of muscle tissue clearly, very clearly. We have 639 muscles in our body. Each muscle is made of so many number of small thread-like structures called muscle fibers. Length of each muscle fiber is approximately 40 micrometers, so that we can understand they are very, very smaller thread-like structures. With that small thread-like structures, muscles are made. With a group of all these muscles, muscle tissue is made. Okay, and these muscle fibers are made of some proteins like actin and myosin. What is the function of actin and myosin? Generally, the proteins actin and myosin, they slide on each other so that they create some movements like contractions and relaxations inside the muscle cell. Due to the contractions and relaxations which are created inside the muscle cell can create movement in the body part. Okay, so we understood now, muscles are made of muscle fibers, and each muscle fiber is made of actin and myosin proteins, and which can create movement inside the muscle fibers so that the organism or the body part can be moved. Out of that 639 muscles, the smallest muscle in the body is stapedius. Stapedius is the smallest muscle in our body that is located inside the ear, which is located nearby the bones present in the ear. Next, the largest and the biggest muscle in our body is gluteus maximus. Gluteus maximus is located inside the thigh, that is from back side of the thigh it is located. And so that this is gluteus maximus is the largest muscle in our body. Okay. Now, what are the different kinds of muscles? The muscles, based on the structure and functions, muscles are divided into three kinds. They are striated muscles, non-striated muscles, and cardiac muscles. Let's concentrate in detail very clearly one by one. First one, striated muscle. What are striated muscles? What is their structure? What is the function of them? Okay, this is what the diagram of striated muscle. Just have a look at the structure of striated muscle. Striated muscle, the name itself gives a complete meaning for us. The word striation means stripes or some lines. Okay, the muscles which have some stripes or some striations on their surface, so that they are called striated muscles. And striated muscles, they contain more nuclei. More number of nuclei are present inside the striated muscles. Okay, where are they located? The striated muscles are present in the body. Where are they present? They are attached to the bones of the body. The entire skeleton or our skeleton system is attached with some muscles. The muscles which get attached to the skeleton of the body, they are called striated muscles. So we understood the location of striated muscles. Striated muscles are attached to the bones present in our body. Okay. And these striated muscles can create movements inside the bones. That means indirectly they can create movement inside the organ where they have the bones. Okay. So striated muscles are responsible for external body parts especially. That muscles can create movement inside the bone so that we can move our hands and legs and neck like that. Okay. So the striated muscles can help in the movement of external body parts. And one more thing, the movement of striated muscles are in our control. How we can say that the movement of striated muscles are in our control? Very simple. If we want to move our hand, we can move. Why we can move like that? Inside this hand, there is bone. There are some bones. And some muscles also attached with that bones. So, the hand can be controlled with the help of some muscles which are attached to the bones present in this hand. So that the movement of these striated muscles are in our control. So that these striated muscles are also called as voluntary muscles. Voluntary. Voluntary means we can move our hands or we can move our legs or we can move these striated muscles whenever we want to move. So that they are called voluntary muscles. Okay, next let's move to non-striated muscles. What are non-striated muscles? Again, let's concentrate on the word non-striated. The muscles which do not have any striations on their surface. No striations are present on the surface of these muscles. So that they are called non-striated muscles. And one more thing, due to the absence of striations, they appear smooth. So that they are called smooth muscles. Non-striated muscles are also called as smooth muscles due to the absence of striations on them. And non-striated muscles, they do not have more nuclei. They have only single nucleus. Here, striated muscles, they contain more nuclei. Here it is a difference. What is the difference? These non-striated muscles, they have only single nucleus. And where are they located? We understood the structure of non-striated muscle. Now, where is their location? Non-striated muscles are present inside the internal body parts. All the internal body parts, just like stomach and esophagus and small intestine and large intestine and kidneys and lungs, all these are made of some muscles. That muscles are called non-striated muscles. So, non-striated muscles are responsible for the movement of all the internal body parts. Okay, and one more thing, can we control the movement of all the internal body parts? No, simply the answer no, because the movement of all the internal body parts is not controlled by us. But the movement of hands and legs are controlled by us because of the presence of striated muscles. And here the movement of internal body parts is not controlled by us due to the presence of non-striated muscles. So, non-striated muscles are also called as involuntary muscles because the movement of non-striated muscles is not in our control. And next, let's move to cardiac muscles. Cardiac muscles, the muscles which are present only in the heart are called as cardiac muscles. So, we can understand, cardiac muscles are present only in heart. How is the structure of cardiac muscles? Cardiac muscles resemble striated muscles in their structure and they resemble non-striated muscles in their function. How they resemble with striated muscles in the structure? Let's concentrate on the structure of cardiac muscles. These are cardiac muscles. And again, on the surface of cardiac muscles, some striations are present. And again, in these muscles, more number of nuclei are present. So, having more nuclei and having striations is a characteristic feature of striated muscles. So that they resemble striated muscles in their structure. And next, where are they located? These cardiac muscles are located inside the heart. The heart is very important part of our circulatory system and which is responsible for pumping of blood from one body part to all body parts and finally throughout the body parts. The blood is pumped to all the body parts, again that is taken back by the blood vessels, so that these heart plays very important role in the circulation of blood. Such heart, such an important organ is made of cardiac muscles. So cardiac muscles involve in circulation of blood to all the body parts. And here the movement of cardiac muscles is not controlled by us. So these cardiac muscles are also called as involuntary muscles. In this manner, these cardiac muscles resemble non-striated muscles. Finally, what we are going to understand here is cardiac muscles, they resemble striated muscles in their structure and they resemble non-striated muscles in their function. So, they are having the characteristic features of striated muscles and non-striated muscles. Okay friends, like this, we understood three different kinds of muscles and their location and their function and their structure very clearly. Thank you for watching.